Welcome to WatchGuard's Daily Security Byte. I'm Corey Nachreiner. Today's story is PewDiePie hackers. First of all, I'm back. I'm sorry I haven't posted videos for a long time. My only excuse was the end of last year was a pretty busy work and travel period. And of course, I took a pretty long holiday for the holidays. Speaking of the holidays, Happy New Year, everyone. I hope you had a Merry Christmas if you celebrate that in your region, and that you're looking forward to a fantastic new 2019. And with that said and done, let's go ahead and focus on restarting this video series with today's first story, PewDiePie hackers. Now, first of all, maybe you've never heard of the YouTuber PewDiePie. If you haven't, he is currently the number one top YouTuber in the world with well over 80 million subscribers and I presume over billions and billions of views. I believe PewDiePie got his start doing Let's Play style video game videos where he basically plays a game and comments on it, but he apparently is a pretty funny guy that many, many people like. While I've seen a few of his clips, I'm not personally a big fan, nor do I subscribe to him. He has sometimes said funny, interesting things, but he's also said some very controversial things, and I personally don't like his attitude with the story I'm about to share with you today. Anyways, if you don't know about PewDiePie, you also don't know about one of the second most popular YouTubers right now, which is a channel called T-Series. And apparently T-Series, which is a channel from presumably a Indian YouTuber that posts a lot of Indian Bollywood-style music videos, is becoming very, very popular. In fact, I think it's just a bit behind PewDiePie with over 79 million subscribers. Anyways, as T-Series has gotten more popular, it's threatened to take over the number one YouTube spot. And PewDiePie has what he calls his BroArmy, and apparently the BroArmy has gone all up in arms trying to retain PewDiePie as the top subscribed YouTube channel. Now, some of their hijinks have been pretty simple and not that dangerous. For instance, a number of other popular YouTubers do support PewDiePie, and they've done stunts like buy actual marketing in their local areas. For instance, one person apparently bought some stickers on big trucks to advertise PewDiePie and get people to subscribe, which is all good fun if you happen to like PewDiePie's channel. But today's story is about some gray hat, and dare I say black hat, hackers that have taken it upon themselves to promote PewDiePie. There's been two such situations. One happened last year while I was on holidays, where one of these hackers, one of them who goes by the name Hacker Giraffe, attacked printers. Basically, using public scanning tools like Shodan, he was able to find a number of printers, I believe over 50,000, that had their print services exposed online. In this case, there wasn't any particular vulnerability in the printers. They were just exposed to the internet, and perhaps the printer owner didn't realize they should be blocking those print services. In any case, Hacker Giraffe leveraged this to force those printers to print out print jobs. The print jobs essentially said, like, your printer's insecure, you should take care of it. But really, the main point of the message was to tell them to subscribe to PewDiePie and to support PewDiePie. Now, the more recent story, which just happened last week or so, or a few weeks ago, was a cast hack. You're probably aware of Chromecast devices. These are little HDMI plugs you can put into your TV that have computers and allow you to stream from phones or computing devices any sort of video to your TV. Besides the Chromecast device, a lot of smart TVs have Chromecast technology built in. And of course, these products come from Google, and the Google Home devices also have casting capability. Anyways, long ago, a couple years ago, some legitimate security researchers found an issue with Chromecast that you could leverage locally. And by locally, I mean you had to be within wireless range of the Chromecast's Wi-Fi signal. Now, using this issue, an attacker could actually force the Chromecast to play anything the attacker wanted on your TV or your Chromecast device. They could also learn a little bit about your internal wireless network. For instance, the Chromecast would share what Wi-Fi network it was connected to, and even some information about the clients that had connected to Chromecast before. In the scheme of things, this isn't a huge vulnerability. It specifically didn't allow the attacker to take full control of the Chrome device as a computer and then get access to your own network, but it did allow you to actually display anything you wanted on the Chromecast. And since then, because it's kind of a local physical vulnerability, Google has not yet fixed it. In any case, that was a flaw that Chromecasts have been vulnerable for a while, but what Hacker Giraffe, the PewDiePie hacker, did was he found a way to exploit this vulnerability over the internet, specifically using something called Universal Plug and Play, or UPnP. As you may know, many routing devices, especially consumer routing devices, support this standard called Universal Plug and Play. It's designed to essentially automatically open holes in your firewall to allow certain internal consumer devices to gain the internet access they need to do certain things. The problem is security researchers have found issues in UPnP for many, many years. Any standard that allows you to automatically open holes in your firewall could be prime for exploitation. And in this case, Hacker Giraffe used UPnP to forcefully allow him to stream video on your Chromecast from the internet. And in this particular hack, again using Shodan, he found over 70,000 devices, Chromecast devices, that were exposed online, and he forced a video on those devices. Now again, the video essentially said, it was a screenshot essentially, it said, your Chromecast is vulnerable to this issue, here's what you should do. But in reality, it also said subscribe to PewDiePie at the end. Now in the scheme of hacks, Hacker Giraffe probably is not malicious. So far he hasn't done anything that would really take control of your device completely or steal your money or steal your information. That said, what he is doing is illegal. Unauthorized computer access, part of the Computer Fraud and Abuse Act in the USA, is illegal no matter what you're doing. I'm actually really kind of disgusted by this attack because it's kind of happening under the guise of security awareness. The fact that Hacker Giraffe is claiming, I'm looking out for your security by warning you of this, is very disingenuous in my opinion when he's obviously just trying to support PewDiePie as part of the BroArmy. I honestly don't care whether or not you support PewDiePie in general and want his YouTube channel to grow, but hacking, even if it's gray hat non-malicious hacking, is not the way to promote this sort of channel. And by the way, that's one of the reasons I can't really follow PewDiePie. In his videos, he actually is promoting and congratulating these sorts of hacks. Meanwhile, he says don't do anything illegal, but these hacks are already illegal. It is too late. His followers have done this illegal thing, which he himself seems to sanction. In any case, I just thought it was an interesting security story to restart my security bytes. And it does have some practical takeaways. While this particular hack is not really the end of the world, it's probably not malicious, you do not want your printers or Chromecast to be taken over by attackers. So, some of the practical takeaways. Universal plug and play. I highly recommend you disable that, especially if you're a business. Now, I can see the argument that non-tech-savvy consumers might like Universal Plug and Play to make some of their internal Internet of Things work better. Nonetheless, if you can do it, I highly recommend you disable Universal Plug and Play and rather manually open the services you really do want to expose to the internet yourself. Now, this could be hard work because you need to learn what each individual network device needs to work online or on the internet. But by doing it manually, you can be more restrictive about the policy so that, for instance, only the gaming service has access to your internal device rather than everyone on the internet. As far as the printer thing, there was no vulnerability there. It was simply a policy that allowed external printing services. So again, having a basic firewall, making sure you have policies that only expose to the internet or outside users things that you really want them to have access to. So really, basic firewalling should have prevented both of these situations. Anyways, if you're a PewDiePie fan, good for you. I'm glad that he's still number one for your sake. That said, I really think this sort of gray hat hacking, especially in the name of a YouTuber that condones it, is a bad thing. And Hacker Giraffe, he is doing something technically illegal. As I hear, apparently he's had a big backlash on these sorts of attacks, so he is somewhat paying for his crimes. Nonetheless, do know you should never be doing these unauthorized computer attacks on the internet. That's it for today's Security Byte. Thank you for watching.